Dear students, I am Santan, working as the physics faculty in Target English Medium School. Today in this part video, I would like to explain some important examples or application oriented questions under the center of mass and the center of gravity, and along with that one important topic also we discussed, that is how to find center of gravity or center of mass of a India map made by the steel. So made of steel, that type of topics mostly we discussed. So in our previous video in the chapter of gravitation, so we are clearly discussing about what is the center of mass and what is the center of gravity, and also what is the center of mass or center of gravity of the objects of different shape of the objects, means where the center of gravity or center of mass is located or presented in case of different regular shape of the object. Now, so generally sometimes during the examinations I am observing that they are asking one or two application oriented question about the center of mass. What is that one means? Center of mass means what we know that and what we discussing that. So the entire or the whole means the point where the entire or whole mass of the particles is concentrated or located. Okay, that point we are called center of mass. Is nothing but at the center of mass of a body, mass is present or not. That is the question generally. So center of mass means it is one of the mass of the particle. We can say that it is located where middle. That is, you know that. But generally, what they are asking, that means in every time. Okay, so means is does center of mass is does mass is necessary or not at the center of mass of a object? Is nothing but at the center of the mass of the object, or where the center of mass is, at the center of the mass of the object, mass is necessary present or not? Okay, so no, because of in certain cases we are observing that at the center of mass of the object there is no mass. Understanding or not? Listen very carefully. Does so mass, does mass is necessary, does mass is necessary or not, it does mass is present at the center of the mass of a object? Explain. Does the mass is present at the center of mass of a object? Explain. So means, so mass is necessary or not to present at the, means so no, means in certain cases there is no need of that one. So I will tell simply for understanding of you, means simply, is mass is necessary is mass is necessary at center of mass of a body, is mass is necessary at the center of mass of a body, a system like this. So this is the making of the application oriented. So what is our answer? No. Okay, so means at the center of mass of a system, in certain cases mass is present, in certain cases mass is not present. But if mass is not present at the center, but center of mass or center of gravity is located at that point only, so no. Okay, so one example we can write. No, okay, we can write example. In case of, a uniform ring, in case of a uniform ring, you are observing that in the uniform ring means like this one. It is the uniform ring. Just we can say that. So it is the center. That's why already in our previous video I explained clearly. So in case of a uniform ring where center of mass is there, okay, at the geometric center or at the centroid of U, okay, ring. This is the center of gravity or center of mass. Means if we can take the ring, so exactly at the middle, what is there? Center of gravity or center of ring. But so at the middle in a ring, what is there? Only the halo. Is it correct or not? Because of along this boundary, only mass is there, but at the center of the ring, there is no mass. But where the center of mass is present? At the center only. That's why. So the mass is not necessary present at the center of mass of a system. Okay. One best example is in case of a uniform ring. At the center of the uniform ring, there is no mass. But at that point, center of mass is present. That is the answer for that. So generally, center of mass is distributed towards where more mass is concentrated. Is nothing but if the mass of the particles are distributed to the which side, that side automatically center of mass is also shifted. That is one. Okay, it is important for the bit purpose. Listen very carefully. If mass is distributed to the any one side, that side center of mass is also shifted, or center of mass is shifted to the towards where mass is distributed. So for example, okay, so here not available. Generally in a 30 centimeter scale, just you can mention that in the 30 centimeter scale, where the center of mass is located at 15 centimeter. Now we can take an eraser. Eraser will be placed on the plastic scale or wooden scale, whatever the scale we are taken, either left side or right side. For example, in right side we place on that. So when you can place an eraser on the right side, at that time, are you balancing the entire scale at 15 centimeter? No. Why? Because actually, what is the center of mass of the scale initially before placing an eraser 15 centimeter at the 15 centimeter? But now an eraser is placed at one side of the, which one, maybe for example 0, towards the 30 centimeter side we place it, then what will be happen? So 15 centimeter is not acts as a center of mass or gravity of that object. But where it is, okay, towards the 0 centimeter? No, it is towards the inside. Means center of mass is shifted towards the 30 centimeter side, because of the mass is placed inside 30 centimeter side. That's why now our finger is slightly moves towards the 30 centimeter side, maybe at 20 like that one, it will be balancing. So what you understand in that way, the mass is placed, for example, if an eraser is placed in 30 centimeter side, the center of mass is shifted from 15 to towards the 30. Is nothing but the center of mass is located between 15 to 30 centimeter. If an eraser is placed in the 0 centimeter side, then what will be happen? The center of mass is shifted, the center of mass is located between 15 to 0 centimeter side. That's why where the more mass is present, that side center of mass is automatically shifted. So based on that one, we discuss that. Explain some suitable examples in which cases the center of mass or gravity will be lie, means is not present in the body. For example, in case of a person, when you can stand on the horizontal level floor like this one, where is our center of gravity? So our center of gravity is exactly located. So it is passing through the navel, means the radius vector, the vector component of the center of gravity is must be passing through the navel of our body. If the same person will be horizontal on the floor, means initially for the horizontal floor you are in which mode? Vertical mode or erected mode. But if a person is horizontally along with that flow, then where is our center of gravity? Exactly at the navel. That's why. So now come to that one. Generally, in case of a human, the center of gravity is located at the navel. When he was standing, the navel, okay, center of the vector component is passing through the navel. If a person will be, okay, along the horizontal surface, means the person is in horizontal mode along the with the surface of the floor or table, so it is exactly at the navel. But now we discuss some important points. What is that one? At what situations where center of mass is, okay, present out of the body? Simply means the center of mass not in present in the body, it is outside the body. For that one, we discussed two or three examples are there. Mainly two examples are enough, but I will explain, I will tell three examples. First one, in a non-uniform ring, simply, in a non-uniform ring, center of mass present at the boundary means simply in a non-uniform ring, center of mass is present at the boundary. Means here, so generally, simply, it is the ring. So this is a which type of ring? Uniform ring. But most you are observing that like this. So it is a which type of one? It is a non-uniform ring because of, okay, from here to here up to this one, mass of the ring is same, but here more mass is present. That's why during this type of one, the center of mass is not at its center. Its center of mass is, okay, on the boundaries at this point. It is nothing but simply where the center of mass is located. From that point, you can balancing the object horizontally. You can balancing the object in the air horizontally from the surface of earth. But here, this non-uniform ring, its center of mass is not located at here. Okay, at here, CG, our center of mass is not located. Where this point means you are balancing this ring by placing the ring in inverted mode at the bottom. Okay, this position, it is balancing. It is nothing but here, what is the center of mass is located, but not at this point. But the radius vector is passing through it only. So this is represented that the center of mass is not present, okay, within the body. It is present in the outside the body. It is nothing but on the boundary of the surface also. That is the first one. Second one, if a person sit in a chair, if a person sit in a chair, the center of gravity or center of mass is present just beneath the below the chair. Means just you can say that so it is a chair, you can say that in a chair, if a person was, okay, sit like this one, at that time, okay, where is the center of mass is of located? Means here. So in this one, we can say the system. System is nothing but a person is sitting in a chair. That's why the stomach mass and person mass both we are considered. When you can sit like this one, okay, in a chair, at that time the center of mass or center of gravity of the entire system of the person is just beneath, is nothing but just slightly below the under the chair. Okay, so that's why in this one the center of mass is not present on the surface, on the body of the person. It is present where? Okay, just beneath the under the chair. Beneath is not what? Just below the chair only. Next, third one. If a person carrying a bucket of water, listen very carefully, not two buckets, only single bucket person. If a person carrying a bucket of water from one place to another place, at that time the center of gravity is present between, okay, bucket and, okay, body of the person, is nothing but in the air. So we know that generally, if, okay, sometimes they are asking that if you can carry the equal amount of water in the two buckets and carrying with two hands, at that time where is our center of gravity? Our center of gravity does not change because of in right hand side bucket how much water is filled, in the left hand side also same is there. That's why, so this side mass is does not change totally. That's why the center of gravity of the vector is passing through the navel only in case of human. But only you can carry one bucket of water at that time. To balancing the center of gravity, you know that you can slightly bend. So if you can slightly bend and carry, means what will happen? So which side more mass is there? Because of the bucket is containing the water, it is, okay, that is also hold in your hand. That's why the bucket of water is also one of the part in our body. In that system, if slightly can bend, that's why mass is distributed towards the bucket. That's why, so the center of mass is shifted from navel to, okay, between the bucket and the body of the person, means mostly in the air is present. Next, like the same way, fourth one. If a person is able to try to touch the toes by bending, if a person will be, so bend and try to touch his toes, at that time the center of gravity is present in the air only. Because of, with help of our hand, we can bend like this one. At that time the center of gravity is shifted from, okay, so now we'll do another place. That's why these are the best examples to understanding of you. In case of a non-uniform ring, okay, at the center mass is not present, but the center of mass is present within the boundary or outside the boundary also. Next, in the case of the second one, if a person is sitting in a chair, the center of gravity is present just beneath under the chair. That's why, so without using our legs, we cannot able to stand by forcing on the floor. Next, third one is, if a person is carrying a bucket of water with his hand, that's why at that time you can bend and walking. So during such a condition, the center of gravity is present between the person and, means it is present in the air between the bucket and the person. Next, fourth one, the center of gravity means, so what is the fourth one? We know that very clearly. If the person is slightly bent and try to touch his toes, at that time the center of gravity will be shifted. That's why listen very carefully. Okay, so in this part of video, mainly we are discussing the only two simple topics only. The first one is, okay, is the mass, does the mass is necessary at the center of mass of a body? No, the mass is not necessary present at the center of mass of a body or system. Okay, for example, in case of a uniform ring, at the center of the ring there is no mass, but the center of mass is only at the centroid of the ring only. That is the best example. Next one, so give some suitable examples. Okay, so where means the center of mass is not present in the body, it is present outside the body. For that one, in case of a non-uniform ring, Okay, the center of mass is present outside the ring, is nothing but on the boundary of the ring. At the boundary of the ring. Second one, if a person is sitting in a chair, the center of gravity is present just below that one. Because of, okay, more mass is located where during the sitting, the total mass will be on the chair only. That's why center of mass will be situated slightly below the chair. Third one, when a person is carrying a bucket of water, the center of mass shifted from navel to, okay, shifted towards the air. It's nothing but between the bucket of water and our body. Fourth one, if a person will be bent and try to touch his toes at that time, okay, center of gravity is present in the air. So this is the best examples. Okay, for the center of gravity is always, means center of gravity is present outside the body. Thank you.